This is the first video in the Forms and Autocrat step-by-step instructions. We're going to start with part one, prepare your Google form. So the first thing that I need to make sure that you understand here, if you plan to use Autocrat to create documents that you want to share to someone else's Google Drive, or you want to email those results to someone else, your student, teachers, whatever, you do need to have a question asking for email addresses. What I do if I'm wanting to share the results with the students is I've got a separate Google spreadsheet with their email addresses in it so that I can just quickly copy and paste that over instead of having to type it. The question fields that you need to have at a minimum are a blank for the student's name, or if you were an administrator doing this for walkthroughs, a blank for the teacher's name, a blank for the email address that's going to receive the data, and then each question that you want to show up on the Google Doc. So you need to be sure that the answer choices are formatted exactly the way that you want them to appear. If you want it to say yes on the final document that's outputted, then you need to make it say yes and not just the letter Y. So let's look at how we would do that. I just go to forms.google.com and I'm going to start a new form. And I'm going to call this Autocrat Sample. And my first question is going to be student name. If you're planning on using this for students to use, like for them to do a peer evaluation of something, then I would go ahead and click to make the questions required, just because otherwise the kids will skip things. I'm going to add email address. And then here, this is where I would ask the questions that I want to show up. So if this is only for you, you can put anything that you want in the question part. The thing that's important is what goes in the options and the answer. So if I were doing this for English, I could just write thesis for the first question. But then for my prompts, my options, that's where I'm going to put what I actually want to come through on the student's document. So I'm going to put zero. Essay does not make an attempt at a thesis statement. I'm going to give it a 0.5. Essay makes an attempt at a thesis, but is unsuccessful. And they get 1 point. Essay has a successful thesis. And I'll give them 2 points as a strong. Okay. So that would be one of the things that's going to be output for my students. So then let me add one more. We'll do hook. And so we're just going to make those really, really quick. I'm going to click up there so that we get the title. So again, the only things that I have to have are the student name, the email address. I have these. Are really for me, thesis and hook. They don't have to be long. These long detailed things are the things that are going to come out for my students. So I'm going to go ahead and stop this recording. This is just the first step. If you have any questions, of course, you are welcome to reach out to me.